G'day everyone, welcome to another episode of Python for the Mindstorms Robot Inventor. Today we're going to learn how to use Python lists to give our robot a sequence of instructions. Hello, my name is Gary, and before we get started, make sure you have checked out all of our previous videos over here because we go through a lot of the basics of Python and we don't want you to miss out on anything, okay? So in order to do this activity, you'll need to have Tricky built. So you just build Tricky, and also we're going to add a color sensor on its back. So all you have to do is get this H-shaped connector, then you attach it to your color sensor, and then attach it to the back of the frame like so. We want the sensor to be attached to port C, okay? Once you have that done, then we are ready to talk about lists. But why do we use lists? So we use lists to organize things, okay? To sort things out, and also anything that requires a sequence, it's very good for that kind of operation. So for today, what we're trying to do is we're trying to get our robot to recognize different colors. And then based on the different color that we present to its color sensor, we're going to get the robot to do different actions. Okay, so if it sees red, for example, then we want the robot to turn towards the right. If it sees blue, then we want it to turn towards the left. And if we give it a white color, then it will go straight forward. But we want to be able to give the robot several steps in advance what these instructions are, okay? And that's where lists will come into play. So let's load up our software. And then go into projects, and then you can go down to the bottom and create a new project. When you create a new project, make sure you click on Python and click Create. Okay, and for this project, we are going to name it Lists. Okay. All right, so how does a list work? Well, first of all, let's connect our robot to our computer so that we can run some very basic code using lists. So wheels equals motor pair A and B. Color sensor equals color sensor at, where's the color sensor? Ah, C. And then let's do an example with my list. And the list is denoted by these square brackets. So these square brackets are right next to your backslash key. So when I go my list equals open and close square bracket, it means I'm creating an empty list. So this list has nothing inside. Basically what goes inside these square brackets is going to be the content of my list. So here, let's make it so that we put in my favorite food. So pizza, pasta, lasagna. Okay, and if I printed this out, then it's going to print out this list out. It's going to have pizza, pasta, and lasagna. Okay, so you open your console and then you press the play button. Here we go, pizza, pasta, lasagna. Okay. If I wanted to add more things to the list, then I would use a method called append. So before I print it out, I'm going to go my list.append, and then I'm going to put burgers. Okay. I run the code again. Here we go. We got 1, 2, 3, 4 items. We got pizza, pasta, lasagna, and burgers, okay? So the append method is the typical way that you would add things to the end of the list, and then it will add things to the last position of the list as you run the command. But sometimes what we also want to do is to be able to find out how big your list is, the length of your list. Okay, and that's going to be really important for us in this activity, because what we want to do is we want to store exactly three instructions. Okay, so three different colors that correlate to three different instructions. So we wanted to check the length of the list to see if there are three items in there, and then if there are more than three items, then it doesn't add any more. Okay, so in order to find the length of a list, we use the length method. And that's what this looks like, okay? So the length method goes like this. So we're going to type more for our print function. There are, and then we go len, that is the name of the length method, okay? The length of my list. So it's going to, instead of writing out the whole list, what len does is it's going to just write the integer of the number of items in the list. So if there are four items, we wanted to say there are four items in the list. All right, let's try this out. So if I press play again, here we got the list printed, and then we have there are four items in the list, which is correct. Okay, and this is almost all you need to learn in order to for us to apply to the next part of this exercise, which is to create a blank sequence, and then to scan using the color sensor different colors, and then if it receives the colors the certain number of colors. If it scans and it receives a certain number of colors, then it stops scanning and then it executes the commands. Okay, and so it's going to run the commands in that sequence. Let's try that out. So now that we know the basics, we can remove these items and then keep my list blank. Then we go while length of my list is less than three. Then we're going to keep scanning with our color sensor. So why are we using a while loop? Because we are repeating something until something happens. So that's why we're using the while loop and not a for loop. Remember, we are using for loops if we know exactly how long a period is that we want to repeat something, but we use a while loop when we want to repeat something until something happens. Okay, so let's go while the length of our list is less than three, then what are we going to do? We're going to go color sensor. Oh, we're going to go color equals, so we're creating a new variable called color, and then we're going to make it equal to color sensor dot get color. Okay, color equals color sensor dot get color. So this is the method for finding out a color from the color sensor, and it returns it as a string. Okay. And what we're going to do, we're going to say if color is equal to red or color equals to blue or color is equal to white. So these are the three colors that we are looking for. Okay, if it's either red or blue or white, then we are going to append this color to the list. My list.append color. And also we're going to make a beep sound. And the reason we're going to make a beep is so that we are going to give the user time to switch over to another color. Because remember, when we are running a while loop like this, then it's going to keep going over and over again, hundreds of times every second. Okay, we don't want to scan a color and then have it enter the same color into the list a few hundred times, because that's not going to be useful for us. We wanted to enter it once and then make a beep so that it gives the user a chance to move away and find another color to scan again. And then that way it's going to limit the number of times that we're adding these colors into the list. So after we append the color, we go hub.speaker.beep. Going to make it a frequency of 60 and a duration of 1 second. Okay. And at the end, after it's scanned three different colors, the list should have three items inside the list. So we're going to print my list just to test to make sure that this is working. Okay, so I'm gonna bring my robot over here. Okay, so that's white, blue, and red. And here we go. So it's printed out white, blue, and red, exactly what we wanted. So now the next part is going to be very familiar. What we want to do is we want to loop through or iterate through the list so that it reads from the first item to the last item, and then it's going to make different movements depending on what that color is. Okay, so you remember how we looped before, right? We used a for loop because we know that there are three items in the list. So we can theoretically use a for loop and make it loop three times. But with a list, we can use a special type of for loop. Okay, so we can loop in the list like this. We go for I in my list. What this does is this is a special for loop where we just put in the list of which we are iterating through. We don't have to tell the for loop the range or the integer of how many times we're looping. When we plug in a list, then what happens is that I will turn into each item in the list as it loops through and iterates through. Okay, so this is a really cool trick from Python. So for I in my list, if I equals red, then what we'd want to do is we want to go wheels.move, and then we said we wanted to go to the right. So let's go half a second to the right. Else, if I equals blue, we do the opposite. We're going to move half a second towards the left. So negative 100. And then finally, whoops, didn't indent this correctly. Finally, we go else if I equals white. Oh, I didn't put in colon after that, blue. Sorry guys, make sure that you put your colons after each of your if statements. So if it's white, then we're going to say to move forward. Okay, and then as a bit of a safety bit of code, we go else wheels.stop. This just makes it so that if there was anything that we add accidentally into the list, it's not going to do anything. It's just going to stop. All right, and that's it. So now if I run the code, it's going to take three colors, okay? I have to scan three colors in, and then after the three colors are scanned in, it's going to loop through each item in that list. If it's red, it's going to turn and move the robot to the right. If it's blue, it moves the robot to the left. And if it's white, then it moves the robot forward. Okay, let's try it, see if it works. So red, blue, white. There we go. Alright, and that's it. That's how we use lists inside Python for the Mindstorms Robot Inventor. As you can see, it's quite simple to use for the context of providing a sequence of information to your robot. And you can tweak it, you can make it so that you give it more commands with different colors, and also you can change the number of commands it receives, and then maybe you can use it as a bit of a maze running robot. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed the lesson today. If you enjoyed the video, please like and subscribe to my channel. It really helps me out, and I will hope to see you again next time. Bye-bye.